Thank you very much, Professor Nomi. I'm Mr. Obata from Osaka University. So I will talk about the part 5, equivalent C2D ratio for correlation of constraint growth in the BM2 ground connection. So this slide showed already, Professor Nomi showed already, the flow of fracture assessment in WAS to A4A. Developing the constraint growth correction is one of the issues for the fracture assessment. So this work focuses on these topics. So this is some fracture scenario of steel frame beam to pump connections. In some cases, ductal cracking occurred from the bottom of access fork. We usually call the scallop bottom. And that ductal crack initiation or extended ductal crack can be the origin of the fracture initiation, the brittle fracture initiation point. And in other cases, initial crack exists at the end, weld end and weld start, the connection areas, and also ductal cracking grows from this initial crack. So this is also can be an origin of the initiation of the brittle fracture. So even though this is beam to ground connections are subjected to bending, so the crack exists at the beam front. So this crack existed in this beam front mainly subjected to tension load. So then the plastic constraint for this crack can be expected to be much lower compared to the, for example, the fracture toughness specimen. So now we are expecting that plastic constraint for that kind of the beam to ground connections can be lower. So then this is the objective. The first we estimated the constraint loss for toughness correction in beam to ground connections subjected to bending moment. So here we use the equivalent C2D ratio operator as engineering definitions. So this definition of the equivalent C2D operator is also employed in the international standard ISO 27 and 306. So in this standard, the operator is given for various wide play with a crack under tension. So this is one example of the given beta values. So by using this equivalent C2D ratio beta, engineering definition of the equivalent C2D ratio beta, we compare the beta for beam to ground connections and the bending moment, and that for a wide plate under tension load. And then we conducted the analysis for the equivalent C2D ratio beta for the component with various crack size. And finally, we try to formulate the crack size effect on beta, taking the specimen thickness into consideration. Oh. Okay, this is detail, but not you couldn't see the detail. I'm sorry. Okay. So I will explain by using this slide. So this is a beam, beam to ground connections. So we modeled the two. We used the two models. One is the crack is located at the bottom of the access hole, like here. Okay, and another one is. I'm sorry. This one. So another one is that the notch is located at the around here, weld end and start, which is connected by welding. So this column and beam are connected by welding through the diaphragm with different thickness and different widths. So, and this is an example of the mesh division. As for the material properties, used the lower yield to tensile ratio of 4.6 in consideration of the Boston paper. So this is a explanation of the toughness correction ratio that we used. So in this work, we used the equilibrium CTOD ratio of beta, and this is the CTOD ratio of the 3-point bent specimen, and also the CTOD for the white plate component at the same vibro stress. And this is based on the, as you know well, the vibro stress criterion. And so, in ISO 27306, in this standard, the engineering definition of beta, and that is the beta at the CTOD for 3-point bent specimen is 0.01 millimeter, was employed. Okay, so then, also we used this definition of the beta. So first, we estimate the engineering equivalent CTOD ratio of beta for the this type of model. So the notch is located in the, at the bottom of the scallop. So we call the BC model 1. Okay, with this model having the surface crack, the conventional scallop 2. Okay, and also the beta for these models are compared with beta for the CSCP. Center surface crack panels under tension load. Okay, so these are the vibro stress for both components. So both are well, almost the same. However, these vibro stress gives a much lower vibro stress compared to the vibro stress for the 3-point bent specimen. So as a result, the beta for both components are almost the same. So this means the beta does not is not influenced by the bending moment in this case. Okay. So next examination is the estimation of the engineering equivalent CTOD ratio beta for the BC model 2. So this model has a surface crust at the well top, well start and end. Like this, okay. And the first, the beta for the BC model 2 compared with the, this model, the beta for this model. So this is a eight surface crack panels with geometrical discontinuity. Okay. So this model almost corresponds to the this part of the connected area. You see, so vibro stress for both components are almost the same. And of course, the beta resulting from these relationships are almost the same. Okay. This means the beta is not also influenced by the existence of the loading mode, bending moment, and tension load. And then, the beta for this model are compared with H surface crack panels subjected to tension load. Okay. Also, it's interesting. The beta for the BC model 2 gives a little bit lower beta values compared to this ESG displacement and the tension load. Okay. Anyway. As a consequence from this result, the equivalent CTOD engineering definition of the equivalent CTOD beta for the speed to cramp connections used in this work can be represented by the beta for the wide plate under tension load. Okay, so then we analyze the crack size effect on beta using these simple wide plate models and the tension load. Okay, the crack size and the crack stiffness are varied like this. And the mechanical properties used in this work is also the low yield to tensor ratio of 0.6. And by conducting this analysis, we try to formulate the crack size effect on beta, taking the specimen sequence into consideration. So, first, we focus on the behavior of crack depth, with focusing on the crack depth ratio to breadth thickness, A over T. Okay, as you see, this is a better for the CSC displacement, and this is for the ESP displacement, under the constant A over T. In this case, 0.24, in this case, 0.14. Okay, as you see, the thin plate provided a larger beta values in both cases. Okay. This is the reason is very simple. Was found very simple. Okay, this is the wide stress for the CSCP displacement with different thickness D under the constant A over T. And these are the wide stress for sequence by displacement with different thickness. Okay. You see for the three-point bend specimen, the crack specimen thickness effect appear in the wild goose chase. However, for the CSC specimen, no difference was observed. Okay. By making use of these results, we make a formula to correlate, to convert the beta values for 25 millimeter thickness plate to the beta with various thickness, like this. Of course, this can be applied under the constant crack depth ratio plate thickness FD. So, applicability of this proposed conversion equation was demonstrated like this. Okay, so red line. So this is a converted result. So these lines are well consistent with analytical data. So finally, by analyzing the crack size effect from beta, this, so we could make a formula to evaluate the crack size effect on beta. So these equations are included in the division of the WES-2808 as a toughness correction method. Okay. That's a conclusion. Maybe time is coming. I'll show you the summary and then I will end my talk. Thank you very much.